So today I'm going to start with chapter French Revolution. I'm going to revise the lesson French Revolution in the form of MCQ. So this lesson starts with Louis XVI. Louis XVI became the ruler of France in 1774. One more question. In which year Louis XVI became the ruler of France? 1774. You have to learn the year 1774. Louis XVI, he was from Bourbon dynasty. You have to learn the name of his dynasty also. Louis XVI was from Bourbon dynasty and he became the ruler of France in 1774. And next, French Revolution, as the name of the chapter is French Revolution. So French Revolution ka bhi year pata hona chahiye, 14 July 1789. 14 July 1789 with Versailles Court. 14 July 1789 is the date of French Revolution. Is it clear? And Louis ki marriage jo thi, Austrian princess Marie Antoinette ke saath hui. Marie Antoinette, she was Austrian princess. And then he was at the age of 20. तो उसकी मैरिज हुई. अब आ गया उसकी इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन में से वन मार्क क्वेश्चन. सर यू हैव डन दिस चैप्टर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सब्जेक्टिव फॉर्म. अब वेरी इजी टू लर्न इन एमसीक्यू बिकॉज यू हैव डन इट बिफोर. इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन में से आपके कौन कौन से क्वेश्चन बन सकते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आपको यही पूछा जा सकता है कि पहले तो ओल्ड रिजिम क्या था. सोसाइटी ऑफ फ्रांस बिफोर द रेवोल्यूशन, लर्न इट. Society of France before the revolution. Next, livre, currency of France. Currency of, unit of the currency of France. Unit of the currency of France that was discontinued in 1794. 1794 में से discontinue कर दिया गया था. Unit of currency of France that was discontinued in 1794. So Louis bought empty treasury need to say. He went to help the 13 colonies of America in their war of independence. And as he had no money, that's why he had to impose taxes on the people, and for this he divided society into three estates. Ab three estates mein se one more question. First estate clergies. Old regime means society of France before revolution. Livre means currency, unit of currency that was discontinued in 1794. Louis became ruler of France in 1774. There was revolution in France on 14 July 1789. Next is division of the society, three estates. First estate, aap bataoge, clergy, people of the church. Clergy, people of the church, priests, bishops. Second estate, nobility. Moneylenders, ठीक है, moneylenders जो होते थे, लार्ज लैंड ऑनर्स, ये सब इसमें आते थे. सेकेंड एस्टेट, फर्स्ट एस्टेट. लुइस डिवाइडेड हिज सोसाइटी इनटू हाउ मेनी एस्टेट्स? थ्री एस्टेट्स. क्लर्जीज, पीपल ऑफ द चर्च, नोबिलिटी, लैंड ऑनर्स, moneylenders. थर्ड एस्टेट, कॉमन पीपल. मिक्सचर ऑफ रिच एंड पुअर. Mixture of rich and poor, third estate. And population wise, which Ponzi estate mein number of people were more in third estate. Ab aapko ye karna hai population wise. 90% of the population, 90% third estate, 10% first estate. Third estate ke log 90%, first estate only 10%. 10% first estate, 90% third estate, and 10% first and second estate. First and second estate only 10% of the population. Third percent, 90% of the population. Third estate owned land. अब लैंड इनके पास कितनी 40% 40% एंड फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड एस्टेट के पास लैंड कितनी 60% 60% लैंड. अब आप अपने आप ही देख लो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. वन मोर क्वेश्चन. सोसाइटी वाज डिवाइडेड इनटू हाउ मेनी एस्टेट्स. थ्री एस्टेट्स. फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड एस्टेट. फर्स्ट एस्टेट क्लर्जीज. क्लर्जीज आपको पता होना चाहिए. पीपल ऑफ द चर्च. नोबिलिटी आप बताओगे. मनी लैंडर्स. लैंडलॉर्ड्स एक्सेट्रा. एंड थर्ड एस्टेट कॉमन पीपल. मिक्सचर ऑफ रिच पुअर एजुकेटेड. ठीक है. नेक्स्ट फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड एस्टेट ओनली 10% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन एंड थर्ड एस्टेट 90% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन. First and second estate owned land 60%, whereas third estate owned land 40%. So is it clear? Now taxes. First is tithe and tele. Tithe and tele. Two kinds of taxes. Tithe and tele. You have to learn. Tithe. It was taken by church and it was 1/10 of the produce of the agricultural produce. It was taken by church and it was 1/10 of the agricultural produce. Tele was taken by state government. It was taken by church and it was 1/10 of the produce. Tele was taken by state government. So people had to pay. Only people of the third estate. Third estate people had to pay these taxes. First and second estate people were freed, exempted from the burden of taxes. Unko koi taxes nahi dene the. First and second estate people were exempted from the burden of taxes. Only people of third estate had to pay all kinds of taxes. And next. All the privileges were enjoyed by first and second estate people. Privileges were enjoyed by first and second estate. No rights were given to the people of third estates. Privileges were not given to which estate? Third estate. Third estate ko koi privileges nahi diye hue the. Privileges were given only to the first and second estate. Is it clear? Tithe and tele were the two kinds of taxes. Tithe was taken by church. It was 1/10 of the produce. Tele was taken by state government. And these taxes had to be given by only people of the third estate. First and second estate were freed from the burden of the taxes. Unko koi taxes nahi dene the. So this was done by Louis XVI while dividing the society into three estates. So that's why people of third estate turned against Louis XVI and they revolted. Tabhi unhone revolt kiye the na. And then subsistence crisis came in France. Subsistence crisis means when everything was endangered, people had nothing to eat. Which crisis occurred in France? Subsistence crisis. People had nothing to eat. Revolt in France was started by peasants. Who started revolting? जैसे मैं बोलूं रशिया में revolt was started by workers. अब फ्रांस का मैं बोलूं तो revolt was started by peasants, by poor peasants, the peasants of the third estate. But due to lack of resources, revolt was carried forward by philosophers. Revolt was carried forward by philosophers. अब philosophers पे आ जाते हैं. Who carried for the revolt? Philosophers. No philosophers. First is you have to only now you have to learn the names of the philosophers and their books. First, John Locke. You have done all these. Who wrote two treatises of government? Kisne likhi two treatises of government? John Locke. John Locke wrote two treatises of government. Who wrote two treatises of government? Kisne likhi two treatises of government? John Locke. John Locke wrote you have to learn the name of these philosophers. First is John Locke, and he wrote two treatises of the government. Next, Rousseau. He wrote Social Contract. पहले तो you have done this topic in detail. Next, Montesquieu. He wrote Spirit of Laws. Spirit of Laws. Then Voltaire. Voltaire, Letters on English. So these were the philosophers of France. Listen again. John Locke wrote, who wrote two treatises of the government? John Locke. Who wrote Social Contract? Rousseau. Who wrote Spirit of Laws? Montesquieu. Who wrote Letters on English? Voltaire. So these are the one mark questions from the topic Goal of Philosophers. You have done this topic in detail, but no, these are the form of MCQ that can be asked from this topic. Ideas, so you know it very well. He criticized absolutist monarchy. He said that there should be social contract between people and their representatives. Montesquieu said that powers of government should be divided between legislature, executive, and judiciary. Spirit of Laws mein. Voltaire encouraged the people of France that rights were given to the people of England. Now you also raised the voice against despotic rule. So this is the this type of encouragement was given by these philosophers to the people of France. वो तो आपने subjective में किया ही है. Now learn the name of your books. ये mix ना हो जाए. ये ना हो जाए Rousseau. Rousseau wrote Spirit of Laws. Then you will get zero for that. Okay, you have to learn Role of Philosophers. अब इसके बाद आ जाता है कि Louis XVI. Now here you have to learn some dates and year तो एक ही चलेगा. 1789. तो डेट्स आपको लर्न करनी है. हाउ टू लर्न मैं अभी बताती हूँ. फर्स्ट मीटिंग ऑफ एस्टेट जनरल. पहले आपको ये पता होना चाहिए एस्टेट जनरल. पार्लियामेंट ऑफ फ्रांस. बॉडी ऑफ एस्टेट जनरल मींस पार्लियामेंट ऑफ फ्रांस. एस्टेट जनरल. Body of Estate General means Parliament of France. Parliament. Name the Parliament of France. Yeah, pick the Parliament of France. Which is the Parliament of France? Estate General, Duma, Reichstag. So, आप किसको टिक लगाओगे? Estate General. Body of Estate General. Parliament of France. अब Estate General की meeting हुई. Meeting बुलाई हुई उसने. On 5th May, you have to learn the date. 1789. Louis called the meeting of estates. Estate general की meeting बुलाई. People of first and second estates sent their 300 representatives. 300 representatives each. First and second estates sent their 300 representatives each. दोनों ने 300 रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स भेजे फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड स्टेट. थर्ड स्टेट सेंट 600 रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स. थर्ड स्टेट सेंट 600 रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स. पीपल ऑफ थर्ड स्टेट केम विद द 40,000 लेटर्स ऑफ ग्रीवेंसेस. हाउ मेनी लेटर्स ऑफ ग्रीवेंसेस दैट इट्स गिवन इन द बुक. सो इट कैन बी आस्क्ड 40,000 लेटर्स ऑफ ग्रीवेंसेस. कौन लेके आए थे 40,000 लेटर्स ऑफ ग्रीवेंसेस? पीपल ऑफ थर्ड स्टेट. हू सैट इन द मीटिंग ऑन द फर्स्ट बेंचेस? पीपल ऑफ फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड स्टेट. हू हैड टू स्टैंड एट द बैक? people of third estate, they had to stand at the back at this meeting. They were not allowed to sit on the benches. Only people of first and second estate sat on the benches, and people of third estate, they were standing at back, came with 40,000 letters of grievances, but no one bothered. किसी ने बॉदर नहीं किया था. नाउ वोटिंग को लेके प्रॉब्लम हो गई. व्हाट हैपेंड? फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड स्टेट डिमांडेड दैट वोटिंग शुड बी डन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ स्टेट. अगर स्टेट के अकॉर्डिंग वोटिंग होती तो उधर तो टू स्टेट्स थी, वो जीत जाते. थर्ड स्टेट डिमांडेड दैट वोटिंग शुड बी डन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मेंबर्स. तो लुईस एग्रीड विद द पीपल ऑफ थर्ड स्टेट, फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड स्टेट. ये आप कर चुके हो सब. क्यों बुलाई थी ये मीटिंग? बिकॉज लुईस वांटेड टू इम्पोज मोर टैक्सेस ऑन द पीपल. नो, ही हैड टू टेक परमिशन फ्रॉम द पार्लियामेंट एज ही हैड ऑलरेडी इम्पोज सो मेनी टैक्सेस ऑन द पीपल ऑफ फ्रांस. बट ही आल्सो वांटेड टू इम्पोज मोर एंड मोर टैक्सेस ऑन द पीपल ऑफ फ्रांस. दैट्स व्हाई ही हैड टू टेक परमिशन फ्रॉम द पार्लियामेंट एंड ही हैड टू कॉल द मीटिंग ऑफ द स्टेट जनरल. एंड अर्लियर दिस मीटिंग वॉज कॉल्ड बाय हिज एंसेस्टर्स. उसके एंसेस्टर्स ने पहले कभी ये मीटिंग बुलाई थी. Louis called this meeting and on 5th May 1789, okay, as the decision was taken in the favor of first and second estate, so third estate people walked out of this meeting. Is meeting mein se third estate ke log bahar chale gaye. Kab unhone meeting chodi? 20th June. Year aapka yahi chali jana hai. 20th June they left this meeting. 5th May को मीटिंग बुलाई. 20th June people of third estate walked out of this meeting, met at tennis court ground in Versailles. Met at कहाँ पे मिले? Tennis court ground Versailles में वो लोग मिले. Name them as National Assembly. अपना नाम क्या रखा? National Assembly. And decided to frame the constitution for France. People of third estate walked out of this meeting pub 20th June 1789, met at tennis court ground in Versailles, named them as National Assembly, decided to frame the constitution for France. अब उन्होंने कहा हम फ्रांस का कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बनाएंगे. कितने इयर्स लगे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बनाने में? टुक टू इयर्स टू फ्रेम द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फॉर फ्रांस. दो साल इन्हें लगे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बनाने में. Leader of National Assembly, Abbe Sieyes and Mirabeau. Learn the name as you have learned the name of the philosophers. इनके भी नाम आपको learn करने हैं. Abbe Sieyes and Mirabeau. Abbe Sieyes and Mirabeau. Both were the leaders of National Assembly. They belonged to first and second estate. Ye first and second estate ke the, but they became the leader of the National Assembly. They were with the people of the third estate. And they became the leader of the National Assembly. Yahan pe ek aapko aur question learn karna hai. Abbe Sieyes wrote a pamphlet. Abbe Sieyes ne ek pamphlet likha tha. Pamphlet. What is name of the, what is third estate? What is third estate? Who wrote the pamphlet, what is third estate? Abbe Sieyes. Who wrote the pamphlet, what is third estate? Kisne likha? Abbe Sieyes ne likha. Abbe Sieyes and Mirabeau were the leader of the National Assembly. Which pamphlet was written by Abbe Sieyes? What is third estate? Yeah, who wrote the pamphlet? What is the third estate? Who wrote? Abbe Sieyes. Who was Abbe Sieyes? Leader of the National Assembly. He belonged to first and second estate. So this is about up 20th June. Ko ye log bahar aaye, named them as National Assembly, decided to frame constitution for France. It took 2 years to frame constitution for France. But on abhi hum constitution abhi ready nahi ho. Hum 2 years mein beech wale टाइम की बात करेंगे. अब 4th अगस्त 1789, 4th अगस्त 1789 नेशनल असेंबली पास अ डिक्री. क्वायर डिक्री, पास्ट ऑफ क्वायर डिक्री बाय दिस टिथ वॉज अबॉलिश्ड. यू हैव रेड अबाउट इट, दैट वॉज कलेक्टेड बाय चर्च. इट वॉज 1/10 ऑफ द एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोड्यूस. टिथ वॉज अबॉलिश्ड, इन्होंने एक टैक्स अबॉलिश किया, दैट वॉज टिथ. देन पावर्स ऑफ चर्च वर टेकन. चर्च हैड वास्ट लैंड, सो लैंड ऑफ चर्च वॉज कॉन्फिस्केटेड एंड ऑन दैट ऑफिशियल बिल्डिंग्स वर बिल्ट. यहाँ पे इतना बड़ा आपको सब्जेक्टिव तो करना नहीं है, तो आपको सिर्फ इतना याद रखना है विच टैक्स वॉज अबॉलिश्ड बाय फायर डिक्री. विच टैक्स वॉज अबॉलिश्ड, टिथ. ऑन विच डेट फायर डिक्री इशूड अ पास्ट अ डिक्री, कौन सी डेट को उन्होंने डिक्री पास की, रूल. ऑन 4th August 1789. तो अभी तक इतना आपको क्लियर हो गया होगा. अब आ गया नेशनल असेंबली वाज बिजी इन फ्रेमिंग कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फॉर फ्रांस. ठीक है, नेशनल असेंबली अभी बिजी है, बिकॉज आई हैव टोल्ड यू इट टुक 2 years टू फ्रेम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फॉर फ्रांस. 2 साल लगे थे बनाने में. तो व्हाट हैपेंड बिटवीन दीज 2 years. फर्स्ट वायलेंस इन पेरिस, वायलेंस इन कंट्री साइड यू हैव डन इन सब्जेक्टिव फॉर्म. अब पेरिस वाले में सिर्फ आपको, अब तो सब्जेक्टिव आना नहीं है, तो आपको इतना याद रखना है वुमेन जो थी उन्होंने किसको आग लगाई थी. दे फायर्ड द बेकरी शॉप. व्हाई, बिकॉज़ बेकर्स होल्डेड द सप्लाई ऑफ द ब्रेड. ब्रेड की, ब्रेड वाज द व्हिच वाज द स्टेपल फूड ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ फ्रांस. ब्रेड, ब्रेड वाज द स्टेपल फूड ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ फ्रांस. वुमेन वर स्टैंडिंग इन द, हैड टू स्टैंड इन रोज टू बाय ब्रेड. And bakers hoarded the supply of bread. Angry woman marched towards Bastille Court. इधर चल पड़ी Bastille Court. Bastille Court. Main power station of Louis XVI. Bastille Court. And woman stormed the Bastille Court on 14 July 1789. On which date and year Bastille Court was stormed? 14 July 1789. Bastille Court को आग लगा दी, and this was the main power station of Louis XVI. Weapons थे इसमें उसके सारे. So this is about people in Paris city. या violence in Paris city. Then violence in countryside. यहाँ पे पूछा जा सकता है manners. Manners, who were manners? People who gave loans to the people, जो लोगों को लोन देते थे by आप कह सकते हो कि उनकी लैंड अपने पास गिरवी रखते थे ये लोग. Manors, manors gave loans to the people by taking their land, उनकी लैंड लेके उनको लोन देते थे. Manors, and in village side rumor spread hui thi that manners hired some people to spoil the crops of the farmers. No need to learn. Yahan pe chatuks aapko learn karna hai. Granary where food grains were stored. Chatuk means granary. Granary where food grains were stored. To yahan ke peasants jo the unhone chatuks pe attack kiya, looted the food grains. Manners ran to neighboring villages with their family members. And angry peasants burnt their manorial dues. उनके manorial dues को उन्होंने आग लगा दी, जो गिरवी रखते थे लैंड, वो वाले सारे पेपर उन्होंने चला दिए. So this happened in countryside, village areas में भी violence हुई. There was violence in Paris, capital of France, Paris. Violence in Paris, violence in countryside. So you have to learn only in the form of MCQ. Then अब आ जाओ, we are doing National Assembly was framing constitution. तो constitution was ready in 1791. अब मैंने पहले ही बोला है 1789 में वो constitution बनाने बैठे. On 20th June they met at tennis court ground, named them as National Assembly, decided to frame constitution for France, and Abbesses and Mirabeau became their leaders. It took 2 years to frame the constitution for France. It means Constitution of France was ready in 1791. In which year France became constitutional monarchy? France became constitutional monarchy in 1791. learn like this. France became constitutional monarchy in कौन से ईयर में फ्रांस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मोनार्की बना? 1791. In which year France became constitutional monarchy? You have to learn 1791. Revolution की date 1780. 14 July 1789. Louis became the ruler in 1774. तो इतने सारे एमसीक्यू हम इतने को टॉपिक्स में से बनाए हमने. फ्रांस बिकेम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मोनार्की इन 1791. लुईस हैड टू अग्री विद द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फ्रेम्ड बाय नेशनल असेंबली. व्हाई? बिकॉज देयर वाज वायलेंस इन पेरिस एंड देयर वाज वायलेंस इन कंट्रीसाइड. सो लुईस हैड टू अग्री विद दिस विद द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फ्रेम्ड बाय नेशनल असेंबली. इन दिस वे वी कैन से लुईस बिकेम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मोनार्क. लुईस बिकेम द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मोनार्क ऑफ फ्रांस विद द कमिंग ऑफ दिस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. This constitution of France starts with the rights of man as citizens. Citizens, rights of man as citizens. अब ये जो constitution है France का, इस constitution ने freedom of speech, freedom of expression, ये सब दी लोगों को. But National Assembly divided the people into two parts. अब आपको पूछा जा सकता है पैसिव सिटीजंस एक्टिव सिटीजंस. हु वर नोन एज पैसिव सिटीजंस? आपने बताना है वुमेन एंड पीपल पीपल हु हैड नो लैंड, लैंडलेस पीपल. या फिर आप कह सकते हो वुमेन एंड लैंडलेस पीपल हु वर नॉट टैक्स पेयर, जो टैक्स नहीं देते थे वो सब हो गए पैसिव सिटीजंस. एक्टिव सिटीजंस, active citizens only male who were at the age of 25 or above and were taxpayer and were property owners. Jo property owners hote the, they were given right to vote. Right to vote was only given to active citizens, not to passive citizens. Right to vote only was given to active citizens, not to passive citizens. So active and passive दोनों बताने चाहिए. Passive में women आती थी and male जो कि property owners नहीं थे, landless थे, जो tax pay नहीं करते थे. And active में आते थे वो लोग जिनका आप कहोगे कि जिनके पास property थी and who were at the age of male, only male who were at the age of 25 or above and who were property owners. प्रॉपर्टी ऑनर जो अपना तीन दिन का टैक्स, तीन दिन के सैलरी जो थी वो टैक्स में देते थे, दे वर नोन एज एक्टिव सिटीजंस. आपको सिर्फ इतना लर्न करना है कि कौन टैक्स, हु वर गिवन राइट टू वोट एंड हु वर नॉट गिवन राइट टू वोट बाय नेशनल असेंबली. एक्टिव सिटीजंस वर गिवन राइट टू वोट. हु वर एक्टिव सिटीजंस? आपको नॉलेज होनी चाहिए. हु वर पैसिव सिटीजंस? वुमेन एंड नॉन प्रॉपर्टी ऑनर्स. तो इज इट क्लियर? अभी आज आप इतना को लर्न करो. अब नेक्स्ट हाँ हम बाद में करेंगे, ठीक है? अब आप अपनी प्रॉब्लम्स हैं तो आप बताओ.